This is the Ender 3 Max. It's about the same size as the CR10. I got sent this beta unit by Creality to do a review. So let's take a look at it right here on Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you every week by the generous donations of these Patreon supporters. Creality shows us on their website as the Ender 3 Max on sale for $400 and sold out. Well, it turns out that's not right. It's just a placeholder. You see, my friend Angus over at Maker's Muse and my other friend Joel Telling, 3D printing nerd, both got one the same time I did. And they did live streams. Joel did his live stream recently. I'll put a link to that. Angus did a live stream before that. And they both put it together, got it to print, and said, basically, it's a big Ender 3. And there's a lot of truth to that. But there are some differences, and I want to cover that. But the size is the big thing. It's an Ender 3 that prints about the same size as a CR10. They advertise it as 300 by 300 by 340, which is really what it measures, which is 12 inches by 12 inches by 14 inches. So it is a big build area, but like I said, the same as a CR10. To start off, it is an Ender 3 base. It's the same size base as an Ender 3 Pro. It's even got the wider rail like the Ender 3 Pro. The only difference is the rail is longer to accommodate a 300 by 300 bed. But how did it get it wider? Well, instead of going on top of the base with these two rails, they go outside the base. So you gain 40 millimeters here, 40 millimeters here, plus the 220 of the bed, there's your 300 millimeters. So you screw these in place with screws on the side going into the base instead of going on top and underneath with the screws. So that gives you 300 wide by 300 deep. What I do like about the Max is it's mostly assembled. The top half is assembled and the bottom half is assembled, so you just have to connect the top to the bottom with those four screws that go in the side of the rails. From there, you mount the LCD, which is exactly the same as Ender 3, and a Meanwell power supply mounts to the back, just like Ender 3 Pro. After that, it starts to get very different from an Ender 3. First off, the extruder top is the same, it's plastic, but it's mounted to a bracket that looks like it came from a CR10 V2. It's got a spot where you can mount a filament runout sensor, but because there is no filament runout sensor, the filament rubs on the edge of this bracket and shaves off pieces of filament. It's terrible. That's got to be fixed. Another thing that's different is a Z-stop switch. It screws right into the rail. There's no T-nuts. There's no slots. You can't adjust the height of the Z-stop switch, which makes it very difficult to adjust your bed. My bed is very loose because I couldn't tighten the springs down far enough because I couldn't adjust the Z-stop. And this has the stronger springs like what's on the CR10, those orange ones that people like to update their Ender 3s with. So it makes it stronger, but it's still loose, it can still move, and it ended up affecting my prints. That's a flaw in the design. One improvement they did is they did two fans for cooling the filament. So it's dual fans, that's nice. So I hope they make this available for Ender 3. And it's got a bracket on the side where you can mount a BL Touch. So that's an improvement over the Ender 3. It still has a single threaded rod at the back and a single stepper motor. That's just like the original CR10 and Ender 3. That could be a problem. And I noticed that when they assembled this bar, I am getting a little bit of sag. So I need to adjust this arm. That affected my bed level a little bit as well. That's just an assembly issue, but it was fully assembled. So in my opinion, they didn't do that right. It does have the filament on the side, like I like to do on my Ender 3s, and it's the same bracket that's on the CR6, and it pivots. But some people still like it on top, so it takes up less space, and this thing is bigger, so putting it on the side makes this really wide, but that's different than the Ender 3. The electronics are the same as Ender 3 Pro, the same bracket, same everything, same SD card upside down. The board is actually the same as the new Ender 3 or Ender 3 Pro. It's a version 4.2.2, and it's a 32-bit board, but doesn't have silent drivers. The V2 has that same board, same number, but silent drivers. So it's hard to tell what you're getting because they don't put a different number on it. But this doesn't have silent drivers. It should have silent drivers. For my first print, I went big, and I was able to use my G-code test print for my CR10 on here, but I couldn't use my corner G-code because the firmware still won't recognize the M0 command. Same problem as V2 and the Ender 3 Pro. But I did go big. I sliced this in Cura in spiral mode. Came out nice. So the first layer went down nice and smooth. That worked great. And that's when I started to have issues with leveling things. I ended up actually having to use a little bit of glue stick because I couldn't get the level perfect for smaller prints. And I printed two CHEP cubes. And if you look at the front of these things, both the X and the Y have vibration in them. And I tightened the belt. I adjusted the jerk on the second one to a lower value. I could not get rid of that ringing. And it's all because of this bed is loose. And that's based on the Z-stop. I can't compress these springs enough because I can't adjust that Z-stop switch. I did print the original CR10 cat, but because of that vibration, it wasn't nearly as good as the original CR10. You know, this is pretty standard Ender 3 stuff. And I wanted to try something different. So I put a 1mm nozzle on this thing. Because to me, if you got a big printer, go bigger nozzle. But I used a 1mm nozzle, and I don't have a good profile for it. And I printed a 300% CHEP cube, and this thing is crude. But it printed it, so it did complete it, but it's crude. So yes, this is a large Ender 3, but you can already make a large Ender 3 if you buy one of those Ender extender kits. They have a 300 by 300 for $129. So a $200 Ender 3 with a $129 kit, that's $329. With their economy of scale, this thing should not be more than $300. So $299 on sale, $279. That's really where this machine should be. And then fix the things I'm talking about. The stop switch should be adjustable. Get rid of this rubbing on here. I like the dual fans. That's really cool. But fix it. And also fix the firmware. Creality, if you're listening, please fix the firmware across the whole Ender line. Ender 3 V2, Ender 3, all your 32-bit boards. They should have the latest firmware available with your configuration files. Version 2.0.7 Marlin fixes all the things. So my G-code will work, so you can do the change in filament. All those things will work if you use the latest firmware. So update it and release it with your config files, including here. And then it'll be really nice, instead of 4.2.2 different versions, just put silent drivers across these things and be done with it. I'd love this. That I'd love to see more than an Ender 3 Max. But I like this machine. I think it's a great direction where they're going. Fix all these bugs I'm talking about, and you got a really good lineup with the Ender 3. So what do you guys think of a big Ender 3 Max? Let me know in the comments below. That's it for this week. If you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the videos popping up. And if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.